Terrapreta Sanitation. Part 6. Highly Productive Organic Farming. Even after a long tradition of organic farming, there are still hundreds of different approaches to it. A big issue is giving back the nutrients to the soil and to keep the helpful microorganisms alive to secure a rich harvest, not just over years, but permanently, because this is the only sustainable way of agriculture. Usually, this is solved by using certain kinds of compost, which vary in substrates or treatment, like Terrapreta, for example. To give you an example of the many different possibilities for highly productive organic farming, we will show you a method by Hervik Pommeresche from Norway, who is the author of the book Humusphere. Instead of composting biowastes, he directly applies fresh organic material as a natural fertilizer, before it is dried out or gone moldy and rotten to biowaste. His yield using this method is just incredible. He produces 18 kilograms of onions on 1 square meter, whereas the common yield only would be 3 kilograms. The theory behind his method is that the plants absorb their nutrients by digesting microorganisms living in the soil. Being a part of the food chain, these microorganisms also need food to live and to reproduce. So the life in the soil, which is estimated to 1 kilogram of bacteria per square meter, has to be fed. All forms of rotten or composted organic material is already been eaten up by microorganisms. Therefore, the appliance of fresh and living organic material seems to be the best food for the living soil. The result is an enormous growth of the plants at the top of the food chain. So, how does he do it? He takes fresh kitchen waste from vegetables and even meat or fish. Fresh green waste from the garden, like grass, can be used as well. Then he adds some water and chops it with a common household blender until it is a slurry mesh or pulp. Then there are three different possibilities to apply the fresh fertilizer as food for the soil. The easiest way is to throw it directly on the field, without any treatment. This should be done every month. Another way is to separate the aquaceous phase by filtration, to use it as liquid fertilizer. The solid phase should be wetted again, and then it can be incorporated in the soil. Therefore, you should cut small furrows, but don't plow the soil too much. The ground mustn't be turned over, because the microorganisms in the deep don't stand the oxygen and light on the surface. After that, you can add your fresh organic material and carefully mix it in. To prevent the fresh material from drying out, it should be covered with a blanket or with a small layer of approximately 4 cm of grass, still allowing the microorganisms to breathe. Fresh, in this case, means that the substrate is not yet dried out, rotten or moldy or smells in any way. Just imagine the microorganisms enjoying fresh greens as you would do. It also should have been produced by organic farming, because the residues of chemical fertilizer and pesticides can kill the microorganisms or reduce their activity. Food or any other organic material, which has been conserved by lactic acid fermentation, can be added as well. This way, even biowastes can be kept fresh and stored before their use. The third possibility to apply the fresh organic matter is to create a living compost. The substrate is mixed with the same amount of soil, which is highly biologically active. The ratio 1:1 results in the most successful soil. If there is not enough food for the microorganisms, they die off. If there is too much fresh organic substance, they cannot digest it completely, and it will decompose and rot, losing nutrients by volatile compounds leaving the soil. The mixture is stored in a bucket with ventilation holes for some time before it is used. This can also be done in a basement or a room of an apartment building, because it doesn't need much space. The result is a living compost soil full of active microorganisms. There's another possibility, what you can do for your plants, blending fresh organic material. Take fresh grass or wheat, chop it in the blender and filtrate. What you receive is called chlorophyll water, which looks all green. it can be used to water the plants. According to the experiences of Havik Pommersche, this helps the plants to recover quickly from looking pale and an obvious lack of chlorophyll. The next days you can already see the difference and the plant is healthy again.
If you are further interested, please click on some of these flickering subjects.